will continue with this venation further. We have already discussed the reticulate type and its classification. Now let us take this parallel venation. Parallel venation can again be divided into two categories. Again, on the basis of how many main veins it has. So it will be called unicostate. Again, the term is same, but this is unicostate and parallel when there is only one main vein or midrib. And here we will call it multicostate when there are multiple main veins. In case of a unicostate, the leaf is going to have only one main vein, and the branches which are going to arise from this main, they are going to run parallel to each other. So this is the main rib, which is called midrib, and the branches, they are parallel. So we don't see any kind of network as was visible in case of the reticulate venation. This is seen in case of banana and canna. So this is a very common example where we find very nicely parallelly arranged the veins and their branches. If here also there are branches, they would be parallel to each other. So we would not see any kind of network. In case of multicostate, again the same thing. We'll have to classify it into two categories as convergent and divergent. Convergent means all those main veins are going to converge towards one point. So if this is the leaf, there are many main veins, and these main veins, they are all converging to one point or towards the tip. The branching, though, is still parallel. So from here, the branches which arise, they are going to be parallel. This is what we see in case of grasses. So here the example is all kinds of grasses, including bamboo. Grasses, wheat, bamboo. These are the examples where we find multicostate parallel venation, and it is convergent. That means many main veins converging and the branches are parallel to each other. Now the divergent type. In case of divergent type, there are multiple main veins, but they all are going in different directions. That means they are showing this divergence. So these are the main veins. And now coming to this part where we are going to see the arrangement of the branches. The branches are going to be parallel. So again, no network, but there are many main veins and they are going in different directions. Example of this is fan palm. So these are the types of parallel venation. Now I said after we understand reticulate and parallel, we'll take some exceptions. So exception means a dicot where reticulate venation is the characteristic feature. Dicot with parallel venation, that is, sorry, corymbium. This is a dicot plant in which we find parallel venation. So this comes as an exception. Now monocot, where parallel venation is the characteristic feature, but monocot with reticulate venation. The example is colocasia. So these are two important plants where we find that in spite of they belong to a particular group, but they show the characteristic feature of the other group. That is, dicot showing parallel and monocot showing reticulate venation. So these two names are important. Now coming to the last type of venation, which is called the furcate. It is a characteristic feature of ferns or pteridophytes. In this case, what happens is the midribs or the main veins are many. So this is the petiole, 1, 2, 3, say for example, 3 main veins are there. So initially they remain undivided, and after that they show 2 branches. That means there is bifurcation. Furcate, fork basically means bifurcation. And that is why this type of venation, which is a combination, is known as furcate venation. Here, we would not see any kind of reticulation or anything. So, lower part has only the main veins, and as we go towards the upper side of the leaf, we find the branching. And every time, it divides to give rise to 2 branches only. Even if it divides, it would give rise to 2 branches. So this is how this venation is, which is a characteristic feature of pteridophytes or ferns. So according to venation, 3 main categories: reticulate, parallel and furcate. Because our chapter is about flowering plants, that is angiosperms, we are restricting ourselves to those examples only. So, on the basis of this venation also, we can identify whether the plant is a monocot or a dicot, because there is a distinct difference between the arrangement of wings. Now, in the next part, we'll talk about simple and compound leaves. What is the difference between these two types of leaves?